Hello guys, my name is Brooklock. I come from Vietnam. Today I would like to show you a tutorial about building Yocto on the Bigbang. This is my document I made it myself. This contains my experience information that I encountered when I built my Bigbang the first time. So for this document, I will attach it to the description of my video. You can download it. So I will skip this document and I'll explain it. My document is based on two sides. The first thing is the free electron side. This contains this website help us train Yocto for free, and it contains very useful material. First thing is the Yocto main website. It also contains the tutorial for that, so that you could view your Bigbang. Yeah. So let's get started. The first thing we need is the Bigbang, right? I usually go to xsub.vn site. This is a Vietnamese website to build Bigbang. The second thing you need is the micro SD card to contain Yocto's root file system. I recommend that you should use 16 GB, but if you would like a cheaper solution, use 8 GB. It's okay. The first thing is the micro SD to the micro HDMI to HDMI cable. We need it to output the data to the monitor for later use in the future. So if you you can skip this cable for now, because in this tutorial we are needed. The fourth thing is USB to UART device. We will need it to obtain a serial connection. So when you have prepared all these or those devices, let's get to the next step. The next step is to install the data. This lab data is a part of free electron Yocto process. It contains the Bigbang layer, so that you could easily build Yocto for Bigbang. There is download the lab data and can extract it. The second is to after you download it, the Yocto labs for zip file, you need to install required packages. Here, just install it. Yeah. Install it and extract it. The next is to go to the Yocto lab and git clone bulky directory. Then go to direct. Then apply patches. Check out to the wrong version and apply patches. The next step is to download Open Embedded TI layer. In the Yongfu Lab directory, just clone it. Check out it to commit to intact TI 2013.03 and apply its patches. The next step, the fifth step is to build environment. First, we go to the Bucky directory and get all the environment variable. From this environment variable, we can put the Yongfu using the data map. So, for example. So after you hitting source hitting source OE in this build, you will enter the build directory. From there, please go to config directory and change the following variable, which is local change it to chip to big one so that the doctor know this is building the big one. Okay. The next step is to include meta TI to file DB layer so that the Yongfu can know about our downloaded meta TI here. Yeah. Okay. To add it to the following direct the location. Okay. So the final step is to run this following command. This process will take a very long time depending on your internet connection, your computer's power processor. It took me about 1 day to finish installing Yongfu. Once you finish, you will have the output in the following direction. From build, go to build directory, go to TMD, deploy. Images, click about. Yes. This is the about file. According to the document, you need this if you build for image minimum. You should need this. This and this. This file and the installation will be discussed later. Next is to set up your SD card. The first thing. So. The story is we need to put our boot file to the SD card so that for SD card it can put the bigger boy can put the linear distribution. So we need two partition. The first thing is the root partition, and second thing is the root partition. Root full partition will contain the files such as Z image. Let's say you would file this file we needed when the bitcoin is in the boot process. In this please notice in this tutorial we will use the window machine for interacting with the pickleball through zero communication Linux, exactly, Ubuntu computer, so that the pickleball, so that we will build Doctor, we will create the disk partition, we will put the output file of Doctor into the SD card here. I use the mobile term to get SSH access to my Ubuntu computer. So mainly during the building, during the setting up, the SD card will be mainly used on Ubuntu computer. So in Ubuntu computer, we will use a tool named fdisk, so that we can easily create the partition, create our file system. Okay. For more detail, please refer to my document. Okay. So after partitioning and creating a file system for both partition root and boot, we need to copy the images to the SD card. So we have two partitions, right? We need to mount the first partition to the directory name boot, and the second partition to the directory name boot. Okay. Copy, and then we will copy is the file to boot directory and boot directory. Here, just do this the following format. Okay. The second thing, which is also important, is to setting up the device. If we don't setting it, we cannot see the output of the digital. Okay. In this tutorial, I use this device to gain the zero communication to my digital. Remember to remember to connect TX pin of the device to RS pin, and RS pin of the device to TX pin. Okay. So after connecting the serial communication, we need to install the serial top. Yeah, this is the serial top. Let's see the serial top so that we can get communication to the bank. Connect your USB UI device to your Windows machine. And configure is the following format you can remember it or maybe different on your computer, okay? So the final step is to boot the button, insert your SD card to SD card hold of your bigger bomb, connecting. Use this cable to connect your bigger phone to window. And then remember this important information. Before we plug this cable to the big button, we need to hold the boot button. The boot button is right here. And then we need to connect it to the computer. Then we release this button. If everything is right, we will see the many messages display on your terminal. See? You see these messages it means that the pickable is completely installed. See that? This is Hoki Electro Check Briefing Restroom message here. So, it's done now. You can browse your. You can browse your file system, build the packages for it, do cross compile. So, thank you for listening. My name is Udo. Hope to see you again in the future. Okay? Thank you.